one of the things that we're seeing in higher ed with, in terms of states and funding mm-hmm. and the impact that it's having in our institutions. Mm-hmm. And as a result, many college universities have to now partner up with private housing companies to develop housing. Mm-hmm. What are your thoughts on that? And have you had experience in developing and working with outside companies to develop housing on your campus?
No, I didn't. I never had that opportunity or that need. Mm-hmm. I do know that occasionally there had been some talk among the business folks on campus that they wanted to at least look into that, and we did. Mm-hmm. We did look into that because at the time the facilities were 1960s, mm-hmm. and you know what that goes with. But we finally came to the conclusion that we did not need to do that. Now, personally, I think that privatized housing is good for universities who are just starting up, who don't have the resources to develop their housing program. I think the privatized housing companies can offer a lot to those institutions, those new institutions that just don't have the funds and don't have the resources to.
Remember when privatization was the evil empire, mm-hmm. and we in ACUHO had conversations about third parties had no role in ACUHO-I, and literally tried to keep them and kept them out for quite a while. Now there's a much more collaborative relationship, as you can well see in the kind of scenarios you just shared, point to that. Of all, and I've been down the road, and I'll get to that in a minute, but of all the aspects of college and university housing, the one thing aspect that I think an institution needs to seriously consider regarding third-party ventures and privatization is what I call the residence education component. Mm.
Privatized housing is part of our business right now. Mm. If we had been responsive to the student needs as they were evolving for the past 25, 30 years, privatized housing would not be with us. Hmm. Students and families wanted new, they wanted private rooms, they wanted the amenities they were used to at home. Hmm. Our industry has great old 25-year-old res halls, community bathrooms, two people to a room. Hmm. Quite often those buildings have suffered from the lack of innovation in terms of renovation. But they were money makers for us, and they also had a debt load that needed to be met through fiscal payment. So I happen to think that the privatization has been positive for us as an industry because it's forced us to speed up the response time. The individual campuses that are responding best to that are taking a look at their housing stock and making serious changes, moving away from the traditional halls for returning students and moving towards either suite style or apartment housing that may not last the 40 years that they were that our original ACUHO-I members were advocating for back in the 50s, but it's certainly meeting the needs. I think we need to become partners with those privatized housing owners. I've seen situations where many of the staff that we have selected and trained to work on our campuses are now being hired as employees of those privatized housing. And I happen to think that's a positive thing because they're coming from our background and they're implementing the same programs and have the same philosophies that we have.
From my perspective, I was on the executive board when we were starting to talk about privatization and everybody was scared to death of it. But there are so many reasons that campuses need private partnerships to work with them. There are many reasons. They may be landlocked in the middle of a city and the private company can purchase that land right adjacent or that property and it can be annexed or become sort of a part of the inventory of the student housing program there. But I think the thing that everybody needs to realize is people in private housing, like myself with Campus Living Villages, we believe in those students. We're there for the students of that institution. We have the same vision and mission as the university. We embrace that vision, mission. We believe in student development. We provide living learning programs, just like anybody who administers university housing. So yes, there's a bottom line that we have, but university housing should have a bottom line too. They really need to understand their financial aspects as well. So it really is not a lot different. We can just be there to help when a university cannot afford more bond payments to build a facility, then a public-private partnership can help with that. So there's just lots of reasons. And each institution should embrace it in their own way. It's not necessarily something every institution needs to do, but there are many institutions that are going to find that through the years, this is the way to go. It's private partnerships are going to be more needed in the future than ever.
I know when I got involved in having to work with private-public partnerships, and this has been, 20 years ago, I wasn't that crazy about it, to be honest with you. I thought, I know best.
Yeah.
I know what our halls are like. I'm the one who's been educated in the field, et cetera. But quite frankly, for me personally, and the University of Maryland in particular, we had no choice. The state had decided that they were going to preserve the money that funded the campus to do things that private money couldn't do. So our money was going to be used on things like building libraries and building academic facilities and labs, and appropriately so. But there was going to be no debt capacity then left over for us to build our own residence halls. And at the same time, we had a wait list of 2,000 people.
Wow.
So really, I had no choice 20, 25 years when we started into this. So, but I have learned over the years, after having had to have been involved in this, that there are some very, very good situations, and there are some very, very good companies out there. And so the way we sort of went about doing this, and I think one of the recommendations that I would make to people if they're starting in this is, first of all, to get the campus to agree that this is a good idea, and that these are going to be our partners that are coming in to work with us. In other words, there's a possibility when one embarks on something like this that if the campus does not understand what's happening, that your facilities maintenance people, your IT people, your police are all going to say, this is a private company. I don't need to help them. I don't need to be involved in this, which couldn't be further from the truth if you want to have a good situation on the campus. So getting the campus to sort of come together and agree, or at least understand what the reason is in trying to develop some private-public partnerships, what the reasoning is behind that, I think will help. The next thing is figuring out who will be good partners. And there are a lot of companies out there that can be very, very good partners, and there are probably some companies out there who are not going to be as good. So picking a team of people that are going to deliver a product to you that they're going to listen to what you think you need, and they're not going to just build a cookie cutter residence hall because it is what they build. And then I think getting the staff to understand that they are our partners. And one of the things that worked really well for us, and now I've seen a bunch of other schools embarking on this, is getting the private-public partner who also builds the facility for you, perhaps to do things like run the facilities and run the administration of the building in terms of leasing. But to agree that the residents' life staff are going to be the people who are in the building. It's going to be your RAs, it's going to be your RDs, it's going to be your area directors. And together then you will partner with their housing management people to make the whole thing work. And if that happens, then I think you've got a greater chance of success, and you have a greater chance of having the experience be seamless for the students who are on campus, and for the students who are going to move maybe from one of your traditional residence halls into one of these buildings. You want them to feel like it doesn't matter. As they're living in one of your residence halls, and the experience is not going to be any less because of that.